What do you think the importance of local theatre venues like the Park Theatre is?
Oh, it's fantastically important. I mean, that's what theatre should be, really. The theatre should be like a great big honeycomb network of individual places which have relationships with their own communities and then make the area in which they live, give it some renown, and people will say, how wonderful, there's a theatre in Finsbury Park which is doing wonderful work, I must go to Finsbury Park. So, it gets the idea of the neighbourhood out to the world. Every small part of town. I grew up in Streatham. There was a huge theatre there called the Streatham Hill Theatre, and it was the number one date for West End transfers, believe it or not. They used to transfer from the West End into Streatham, and there was great excitement around the theatre, and that's something that every neighbourhood needs.
Of course, tonight's production is about some very timely and political subject matter. Sometimes people criticise that, how political our art on the screen and in local theatre seems to be. What would you say to people who question how politicised our art is?
Well, I don't know whether it's being politicised or not, but it's just being about what we all face and deal with in our lives. And some people might say, well, I want to escape from that, which is reasonable, and that there should be theatre that escapes from life, but there also should be theatre that deals head-on with it, because after a while people look up on the stage and they say, but life's nothing like that, I don't believe in that. These are the things that I'm worried about, and that's what the theatre should deal with as well. It's always a constant interchange with the audience, because we learn from the audience, and the audience maybe learns from us as well.
I think that's what defines the experience of live theatre, both for performers and audiences, from other forms of entertainment, that connection, that immediacy.
Of course. I mean, it's the interactive art form. It's true to say that we change as a result of the way the audience responds. The play changes every night. Nobody, not the most technically ruthless person, actor, can give the same performance every night. We change because of the way the audience is listening to the story. And they tell us about the play. We don't know what the play is like until we do it in front of an audience. And equally, we hope, they're surprised by what we do. And so there's this kind of lovely mutual discovery. We're surprised by the way they take it, and they're surprised by what we're saying or doing for them.
What are you working on yourself? Where are we going to see and hear you next?
The next thing I'm going to do is a film in New York. In fact, next thing I'm going to do is to go to Moscow to do a concert. I'm a bit nervous of it, actually, because I'm doing the music that William Walton wrote for Henry V, and I'm doing some of Henry V's speeches, including Cry God for Harry, England and Sir George. I don't know how well that's going to go down in Moscow just at the moment. After that, I'm doing a film in New York, or rather in Brooklyn, and then the Edinburgh Festival, where I'll be doing De Profundis by Oscar Wilde, which I did at the Vaudeville Theatre earlier this year. So I have much on my plate.